Zu Gast hier am Fonds Professionell Kongress 2018 ist Jean-Claude Trichet, einer der Keynote Speaker bei unserem diesjährigen Event. Er war von 2003 bis 2011 Präsident der Europäischen Zentralbank und hat uns einen interessanten Vortrag hier am Kongress geboten. Jean-Claude, you mentioned in your presentation that the financial crisis, which is now 10 years over, has to be judged as a crisis of the advanced economy. Why that clarification?
Well, I think that it was obvious that the epicenter of the crisis was in the advanced economy. It was very obvious, of course, with the subprime crisis, first episode, with the Lehman Brothers bankruptcy, both episodes in the United States of America. Then we had, unfortunately, an part of the crisis which was concentrating on sovereign risk crisis, and there it was Europe that was the epicenter of the crisis. So clearly the emerging world, neither Latin America nor Asia nor any other significant emergent economies or countries was part of the epicenter of this particular crisis. When, as you know, of course, the Latin America crisis was an emerging country crisis, the Asian crisis was an emerging country crisis, the crisis of Soviet Union was a country in transition crisis, but the advanced economies were, until 07, 08, protected from being themselves the epicenter of a financial and economic crisis.
You are, in my view, the first economist who is talking about a notion that you call conceptual convergence in regard of the policies of the different central banks in the developed world. What is behind that idea?
Well, it is the very, very important phenomenon that in the crisis, because of the crisis, because central banks in all their own economy had to behave as the major anchor of stability in a period where turbulences were really dramatic and where the threat of a Great Depression of the type of 29-30 was obvious. Again, in all the advanced economy world, and by way of consequence, in all the global economy, the central bank have pragmatically, for reasons that are due to the gravity of the phenomenon, converge, not because they had a meeting and they decided to converge, but converge de facto in a number of dimensions. I would not say all dimensions, but in a number of very important dimensions, namely prevention of systemic risk, of course, immediately associated with the lessons of the crisis. Also, convergence towards banking surveillance, micro banking surveillance, which is something which was not the case before, and is also a consequence of the crisis, obviously. And I would also mention communication. And of course, last but not least, the fact that all major central banks of the advanced economy have, at the moment I'm speaking, the same definition of price stability or definition of price stability that are very, very close, namely the figure 2% is pronounced by all major advanced economy central banks, all those who are issuing the currencies that are presently a member of the basket of the SDR.
Regarding regulation, it is obvious that in the US we can see some obvious tendencies of deregulation. In Europe, we are all the time talking about more regulation, MiFID II, and etc. Does that enable the different central banks at all to follow your concept of conceptual convergence?
Well, this is a very important issue, which is also associated with the new direction that the executive branch in the United States of America is suggesting. My sentiment is that we are still living in a world which is full of challenges and of dangers, and financial dangers in particular. We have various elements which are not calling for complacency, including the leverage. Global leverage is continuing to augment in a fashion which is dangerous. In this universe, it seems to me, of course, the overall regulation must be very well designed, and you have to take into account the positives and the perhaps the, I would say, negatives associated with excess of regulation. But at the present moment, in the present world, I would call for continued close cooperation between all countries concerned, of course all central bank concerned, and I don't want to interpret too much what the Fed might think, but it seems to me that the Fed itself considers that appropriate regulation in the present world, with all the challenges, might still be necessary. In any case, I do not consider that it would be possible for the not only the central banks, but all the authorities concerned to depart from the very close cooperation which has been reinforced in the crisis, in particular in the Basel format and under the auspices of the G20. And I would certainly call for continued very close cooperation.
All that implies that we have to be vigilant of the possibility of a new financial crisis, which then would be a real global crisis in your mind, as you call it, instead of a crisis of advanced economies that the development from 2008 has been.
I think we have to consider that at a global level, the situation is still very demanding. In some respect, in terms of leverage, even more than before the crisis. Taking into account the leverage which is observed and the increase of leverage which is observed in the emerging world, it is possible that the trigger of the crisis would be in the emerging world. I don't exclude that. I hope very much that it won't be the case, and that because we would be more lucid, more aware of the risks at stake, and correcting the trajectory in trying to, instead of having a bias in favor of indebtedness, which is presently the case, clearly, all over the world, to have a bias in favor of equity in general, equity in the private sector, and also, I would say, taxation instead of excessive indebtedness at the level of the public sector. If we are lucid and take really this very dangerous evolution at stake, I hope that we will avoid, of course, the new catastrophe, which would not be forgiven, in my opinion, by the people in our own countries. If we see a level of opposition to global, I would say, cooperation, global governance along the principles that we follow since a very long period of time, it is because we had the crisis. The people in our own countries are not forgiving the crisis. And that's the reason why we should, you know, step up and avoid a new crisis.
Thank you very much, Jean-Claude Trichet.
Thanks. You. Thank you.